Hello everyone, welcome to e-learning nuggets. In today's video I'm going to teach you how to solve the math class output functions. What I mean by that is they will be giving you some math class functions and you are required to write the output for those statements or expressions. Let us begin our lesson now. So we'll see the math functions output problems which will be asked in the exam. It will be asked for part A for 2 marks. Questions will be like this. What are the final values stored in the variables x and y below? They've given the values of A and B. A is given as -7.35 and B is given as 14.74. And two questions are asked. Each will carry 1 mark. Let us solve one by one each. Okay, the first question here that you have is double x is equal to mat dot absolute of mat dot seal A. See, always we have to solve the inner parenthesis first. That is, this should be solved and whatever result you get, that should be applied to the outer math function. Okay, so that you have to remember. So we need to expand this value. So here it will be x is equal to mat dot absolute of mat dot seal. What is the value of A here? It is -7.35. Don't forget the minus sign. See, okay, -7.35. So we need to put this value -7.35 here. So now we have to first solve this particular part, that is mat dot seal of -7.35. What does the function seal do? See, I tell my students, seal means the ceiling which we see over the top, okay, of a room. So this ceiling is in the top. That means here it will round off to the highest number. So if, for example, if I'm having this number 7 plus 7.35, if I had, the highest number to this would have been 8. But you have to notice here I'm having a minus symbol here. Okay, it is -7.35. So since it is -7.35, you can briefly draw the number line in the side if you want. Okay, 0, this is the positive number, this is the negative number. And where is your -7.35? It is between your -7 and -8. You have this number -7.35. Now we want the highest number. So since it's a negative number, we know -7 is greater than -8. So the result here will be -7. Because -7 is bigger than -8. So here the value will be x dot math dot absolute of -7.0. So if you observe here, the return data type is a double. So here it will be x is equal to absolute. What does the function absolute do? See, absolute function, what is the use of the absolute function? See, absolute function, what is the use? Absolute means it is like this, mod. Okay, so if I put here -3, the answer would have been 3. Here we are having -7.0. So answer here will be 7.0. So this is the answer for the first one. Okay, now see, there is a second one that is asked in that same question. Okay, okay. So here if you see, the value of A is given as -7.35 and the value of B is given as 14.74. Okay, so here also they have given the return type as double. That's the reason we have to put 0.0. So first mat dot rint, you keep it as it is. Always solve the inner loop. Okay, the inner brackets, parenthesis, you have to solve. So mat dot max of A comma B, which is this -7.35 and 14.74. Always remember the positive number will be the bigger number than the negative number. If it is +3 and -3 also, +3 is considered to be the bigger number. Though they are equal in their magnitude, you have to consider +3 as the bigger number. So here, which is the maximum number we have? 14.74. So here, rint. Rint function will round to the highest integer, the next highest integer. So which is the next highest integer we have? After 14.7 is given. So it is more than 0.5. So this will be 15.0. So the while now let us look at the third problem. The third problem says if they've used an array here, okay, if int n n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, 13 and 16. What is the value of x and y? So, in this they've used an array of n. So, we can just draw the array like this. In the exam also you can just do this. Okay, 5, 7, 9, 13 and 16. And we all know that array numbers, it starts from 0, the index value. So, you write it like this. Okay, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 numbers. So, it starts from 0 and ends up with 7. Okay, so here the two questions that is asked here. Okay, math dot power of n of 4 they've asked. What is n of 4 for me here? What is n of 4 here? So you see it is 7, comma n of 2. N of 2 is how much? It is 3. That means it is x is equal to math dot power of 7, comma 3. Okay, 7, comma 3 means it is 7 cubed. It is equal to 7 into 7 into 7. That means it is 49 into 7. That is equal to 343. So, the value of x here is 3. Let us continue with the second part of this question. Math dot square root of n of 5 plus n of 7. So, I have written it here. So, here what is n of 5 for me? This is the 5th index. So, n of 5 for me is 9. Okay, n of 5 is 9. And what is n of 7? N of 7 is 60. So, here this particular thing, it will be math dot square root of 9 plus 60. So, math dot square root of 9 plus 16 is 25. So, this is 25. So, here you will get this square root of 25 is how much? Square root of 25 is 5. So, answer will be 5.0. Okay. Hope you understood this problems. Got one more, two more here. Yes. So, this is comparatively easy. So, we can do it directly. First, we have to do the inner one. As I told you. First, we have to do this. What is the maximum between 9 and 16? It is 16. And what is math dot square root of 16? Square root of 16 is 4. So, square root returns a double value. So, you write a 4.0. Next question. Name the mathematical function which is used to find the sine of an angle given in radians. So, they have just asked you to name the function. What is that? Math dot sine. You just put a x here. Name the mathematical function used to find the natural logarithms. Logarithms means what will you write? Math dot log. Okay. So, log if you write, you get the marks. Okay. So, this is another question. And here one more I have. The last one here. What are the values they have asked? So, here also, see if you observe here, we have first one R1 as math dot absolute of minimum. Minimum means which is the smallest in these two values. I told you when you are doing on the number line, minus 2 will be greater than minus 5. So, in this minimum will be this number. So, this is minus 5.83. Absolute means you have to just remove this particular sign. Okay. So, answer will be just 5.3 plus 5.3. The next one you see R2 value. It is math dot square root of floor. What is the floor? I told you seal means ceiling on the top. So, here in this floor means it is the floor which we are all standing on. That means it is to round off to the lowest number. So, which is the lowest number? So, this will be between the 16 and 17. 16.3 will be found between 16 and 17. So, which is the lowest number? 16. So, here it will be 16. And what is square root of 16? It is 4.0. We are putting 0.0 because all these values are going to return a double value. Hope you like this video. If you like, please share and subscribe. Thank you.